Now on 4, challenging beliefs on the street causes strong language and graffiti wars.
Advert for yourself. It's not conforming to normal society. No one should tell you how to live and what to do. So fuck the government, fuck the law, fuck all them people who don't understand it and who don't want to understand it. This is our thing, this is our way of living.
Where'd you get your paint, Pips?
I get it from like B&Q or Great Mills. Little paint shops.
100% discount, don't
you? Yeah, 100% discount. I have like certain times when I know when shop stocks up and everything, and I have it like all wired out. And I just go in and then I just like just empty shelves with paint and just wait till they stock up again. Just use it all on bombing.
I've got some nozzles that we use on the top of cans.
Yeah.
This is a fat cap. The filling in. You've got your fading cap, which is that, which can fade colours together. And your skinny cap, which is that, which I've used. I mean, final outline, really thin like.
Sheffield is at war with graffiti. Not long ago, a notorious graffiti writer was sentenced to 5 years in jail for criminal damage. To win the war, the city's grimebusters squad is on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
If you had a car and I went and drew a beautiful eagle on the bonnet, some members of the public says, oh, that's a nice eagle. But yet you don't want it and it's your car, then why should you have to? You know what I mean? I mean, if somebody draws something on your wall and you don't want it, then it just shouldn't be there, should it?
Someone's cleaned it. What you cleaned it for, I'm going to write on it again. No point in cleaning it. I don't want to get written on again.
Most of the graffiti in Sheffield is tagging. And of course, the idea of that is to get your tag in as many places as you possibly can.
Your tag is like lowest form of graph, it's like a stylized signature. Then some tags you throw up like a bubble letter filled in, two colour maybe, to a piece, a bit more elaborate, full colours, design stuff in letters and then like a full wall like a production.
I'll be honest with you, I wish I didn't have to remove it. I mean, it's unnecessary filth. You know, that's all it is, unnecessary filth.
You get famous for writing your name and, like, other people see it in your own little circle of graffiti writers. Do you know what I mean? Fame way, that's how it works. Like, people, you know, graffiti writers see it when it goes past on the buses and whatever. You know, wherever you are, it could be anywhere in the city. And, like, we've bombed some buses and stuff, and someone else over the other side of the city sees it go past, you know. And, like, for me, that's a bit of fame.
They will always put it on faster than we can remove it. But we just have to keep banging away at it, keep removing it, so that it's not there for very long, and that's the secret. It loses its purpose to the taggers if it's only there for a day or two. They want it to be there for a week, a month, forever, whatever.
grimebusting squad, man. Fuck grimebusting squad, man. They aren't doing note, man. They ain't got a clue. Try and buff me. Because I'll tag your vans. Break it down.
You know my crew. Each master to his own technique.
You know my crew. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I break your concentration?
Saturday night. Chrome's party is a prelude to tonight's tagging and a chance for Fibber to brag.
Hey, you what the hell, man? When did you do that? I run around all the van yards. And they were like, because like, I can ride with both hands yet. And just like, because legged it through this van yard, like, just fucking bombing everything, man. Hell, man, it was wicked night.
1 a.m. This gang of four can put up 300 tags in a night's graffiti bombing, as they call it.
Time to move on, can't freeze, cause I'm blessed with a gift from God that can't seize. As my thoughts manifest into words, I lay a speech upon the minds that are bonded. I'm trapped in a sleep, take a journey with me into my dream and see my nightmare. I can hear footsteps, but when I turn around, nobody's there. Spooky voices penetrating my ear with the smell of decay. In the cold night air, I feel the fear so cold.
Sometimes you need to feel that you're nothing and you've got no control. You're told what to do, advertising, politicians, blah de blah, everything pushed in your face. Buy this, buy that, do this, do that, shop here. It's just money mad sort of thing, you know. People chopping trees down and selling them and big corporate stuff polluting the world and that. And that's like real vandalism to me. And then they make a big thing out of like a few scrolls or like a few kids wanting to have a say.
Mist is fighting inside the graffiti scene too. His former Graff friends, Easel and Dee, are on the brink of setting up a legitimate graphics business.
In the early days, or in the early stage of being a writer, it is about getting a buzz out of like fighting the system illegally and because they say it's illegal. But I don't know, if you progress and you are creative, you spend more time thinking about your work than your opposers, you know what I mean?
I know, like, people who are into legal stuff and it's... Have they really got choice where they want to paint and what they want to paint? I wouldn't say so, or when, how often they can paint. They only want to do legal stuff and they'll slag down where they've came from, old culture writing, to get legal work. So try and make themselves look better, but I think they're like sort of traitors if they're just pure legal.
All we want to do, speak of D, is just like create and just be more progressive in any media, really.
Yeah, we get that sold out lyric, which goes through the culture of if you cross a certain boundary, you've sold out. I think probably what it is, if you make money and you're successful from it, you're sold out.
The only reason why it bothers me is because it's someone that I've known for a long time.
I pity them, me.
It's just for them to form an opinion like that is wrong.
In a way, they can be worse than authorities. People like that, they forget how they started.
Mist and Easel were once in the same graffiti crew, but they're growing further and further apart.
I'd say I have got responsibilities that other writers haven't got, and that's, for one, a family.
Hey?
What
about feeling anyway? It shouldn't be a problem. But I'll try and do it about 6 or something, I don't know. I might go shopping after I've tucked him out.
It makes it really difficult, because I know that I've got to answer to someone else as well as myself.
Yeah.
Easel and Dee have a schedule of meetings to try and finance their new business. The illegal writers apply their strategic thinking to getting close to trains. In tribute to their origins, New York graffiti.
Right, so from our last meeting, drawn up some points that we discussed, looking at training...
To go legal, Easel and Dee have to show the Sheffield Community Enterprise Development Unit that they have a head for business.
And I think it's we want to make that shift from community-based to private to get the overall sustainability, probably a balance of each.
Mm. A very useful thing to have when you're trying to attract support for your organisation and get people to show faith. It starts with your business plan. Mm-hmm. You found some premises, haven't you?
Yes.
So within this facility, we would look somewhere to actually bring people, mm-hmm. show them what operations are going on now, show them that we've got a site, that we mean what we're saying, you know, mm-hmm. it's not talk, it's a well thought out, developing project with a plan behind it and with some commitment behind it. There's going to be some work about.
Under cover of darkness, Fibber has a different mission. His goal is to plaster the whole city with his name and achieve graph fame.
It's just like a buzz, like an adrenaline rush. Like, your eyes are everywhere, you're dead aware about everything. I don't think I will get caught. I'm just arrogant-minded that way.
He may call himself Fibber, but he'd be a liar if he thought he'd got clean away with it. Overnight, his tag appeared on shop fronts in the high street. Cleaning it off won't be cheap.
Some guy at 2:30 in the morning, on Monday morning, he decided to walk up the high street towards us, and he sprayed the wall, wrote his name on it, and then gradually made his way up the high street spraying different shops and premises.
The culprit was caught on video, daubing the front of Dean's bar. He's now handed the tape to the police, who are trying to track him down.
Now entering rail track property. Rabbits and writers only.
They might say that we're a menace to society, but at the same time I say, why is it me? Am I the target for destruction? What about the system and total corruption? I can't work at no fast food joint. I got some talent, so don't you get my point? I've never been afraid to let loose my speech. My brothers know I kick the code up the streets.
Another day, another bombing mission. Mist and his crew hit old carriages in a railway siding, a warm-up for the much riskier venture of attacking trains in everyday use.
There's a known fact that his parents just don't understand. Simple as that. No disrespect to anyone at all. They lived in the 60s, and like we lived in like the 80s and 90s.
I work at police headquarters, just basically a general dog's body. The only thing that worries me is if he gets arrested for it and ends up in my cells.
I'm not bothered anyway. Well, I ain't been arrested for a few
years.
He's
all right now, actually. He only does it on bona fide sites. Once he was arrested, and I had to go down to the police station with him. And I told them then to give him a short, sharp shock, and it was the establishment's fault for not doing that, not putting these bloody vandals in their place. If he started that again, well, he could be on his own. He could do, you know, I mean, I couldn't do anything about it. He'd be on his bloody own. I wouldn't bother with him.
Legal writers Easel and Dee choose to go public in a different way. They decide to paint a free piece at the new skate park to raise the profile of their new company.
2, 3, 4!
probably be a one colour background around the lettering. Probably. I'm just not happy about that on top. I think it's a bit squashed. It's going to take a little longer, I think. Could get it done today, but we want to make a good job of it. So we'll take us time on it.
They're just interested in pretty pictures and trying to please. They're more trying to get, like, public as an audience, as not other writers. They're just slagging down other writers to get attention for themselves. If I could make a living out of it, I would, but I wouldn't forget about real stuff. That's what drives me anyway. To paint trains, to see it running, to see it wherever I go. Like technical ability is one thing, and then having true feeling from your heart is more important to me. Even though I can do some technical ability shit like.
When you're in town, you've just got to watch your back, haven't you? Because anybody can walk past and pass on the information to somebody else, and then it's not so much getting caught, it's getting caught and stopping. You've got to stop what you're doing. And that's what's the bummer to me anyway. I think it'd be more watching your back all the time. I don't want to do that. Don't feel comfortable.
They're scared of getting locked up, they're scared of getting the freedom took away, but they're just scared to stick the necks out. They're saying we're doing it all wrong. It's because they don't do anything. They've sold out, they just want to make money out of it. That's the only way they can do their graph.
Taggers like to think they live dangerously, but I don't know, I just see it as a waste of time, really.
They say we're wasting our time. Well, what else are we going to do with time anyway? Fucking sitting in the house doing no. I mean, I've been on, like, Sheffield scene, then we broke away onto the national scene, then international scene. Well, what has he done? Fuck all. You know, if you went out into London and ask who he were, nobody would know, you know what I mean?
Oh, counting hours, I'd say around 40, 50 hours altogether. But we just took us time. It's a nice, relaxed atmosphere. It's not outside or anything, no weather to worry about, so just took us time and enjoyed it. Well, this bit's fairly self-explanatory. Ideas, where do they come from? This is us. This represents us non-stop on the top of our building with creativity flowing. And there's the non-stop. This bit here, I like. This is a message for certain people, something that you'll never get, never. My mania is reading our upcoming magazine, which is just the facts. And a small city in the background, in a valley. I wonder where that could be. Got lots of work to do, especially coming away from here.
I'd rather see tags than nothing. So, like, there's missed one there, and where's your name? Easel. Where's your name? I'd rather see trains done than pieces on walls. I've got them. Where's this? I mean, it seems to me, I'm saying more than he is. If he's saying fuck all.
In graffiti, anyway, you do thrive on recognition. But probably because of my bad attitude and way I speak to people, because I am passionate, that people don't like me, but I don't care. Because I'm going to get done what I've got to get done at the end of the day. No matter what they do, no matter what they think or say, fuck them.
Mist also feels that he has to do what he has to do, and that's bombing trains in use, the pinnacle of achievement for the illegal writers.
Every serious writer should be aware that there's a good chance you'll go to jail for what you're doing. It's basically you are saying fuck you.
Mist and his partners in crime wait until daylight to admire their work in motion.
You're a metro fucking train maintenance man. You're going to have a great fucking job. Man, you're going to be busy for a few fucking weeks, man. We just smashed your yard, man.
The railway operators and police view this vandalism as a serious and dangerous crime. They want the graff writers to be punished and to pay for the damage to the property. Easel and his colleagues have had some success. The Sheffield Community Enterprise Development Unit has secured funding for 3 years to cover rent. Now they have to find office space.
All right.
There you go.
How's things?
Not bad.
Good.
I still think it's spacious, man.
It's not bad, is it?
So what will you be having in this space?
Could just be mainly design, confidential room, and training area,
right,
as we're thinking, and all important coffee area.
Yeah.
A piece in motion, it's like, you know, it's hard to explain, it's such a good feeling. When your piece is on a train or a wall and it's for yourself, it can't be ripped down and sold, it's for you and for writers. It's there for free for people anyway, so they don't have to buy it.
You don't regret not being in train yards and that sort of thing?
No, I'd rather be tucked up in bed, sleeping, thanks. So I can get up and work hard all day on what I love.
But Fibber's nights are still spent on the streets. Graff notoriety breeds confidence, as fellow tagger Chrome explains.
Yeah, I won't get caught anyway.
Do you not ever
lie
in bed at night?
I've been doing it for so many years. I know how to dodge anyone, whoever it is. I can dodge anyone. You know what I mean?
I'm surprised by your...
Well, I don't have
I know you're a confident man, but I'm surprised by your confidence nevertheless. You know, it's like...
Yeah, but it works though, doesn't it? If you've got good confidence, you know.
But confidence may not be enough for Fibber. The police are still after him, and he's been threatened with violence by the owner of a van he tagged.
Read about that Rasta's van. Apparently it's fucking coming down like to fucking battery or something.
Yeah.
Really, like, he reckons that he's got me addressing that, like, but...
Hey, you've made one mistake, fair enough, I mean...
Yeah, and it's like, with this bloke coming after me, like, do you know what I mean? I'm going to end up fucking learning from it, you know what I mean? But...
Yeah, but he won't find you anyway, you know what I mean? That's
well, I hope that he didn't find me in that, like, you know what I mean? But...
In spite of the threats to him, Fibber does not stop bombing. 2 weeks later, he and Chrome are caught red-handed, tagging in the city centre. They were fined a total of £640 and ordered to do 240 hours of community service.
That was the last in the series of short stories. Next Tuesday at 11:05, Journeys into the Outside with Jarvis Cocker, starting in France. Celebrating an institution next on 4, arguments for and against the big top in Circus Days, Circus Nights.